You might have seen a test like this one in a questionnaire before. One that asks you, on a scale of 1 to 10, how you feel about something, 1 being the coldest and 10 being the warmest. But what if the test asked you to rate your feelings toward a certain race? Seems really forward, right? That's because this is a test for explicit bias, which refers to the attitudes or beliefs we have about people on a conscious level. But every person has something called an implicit bias, which refers to the attitudes or stereotypes that affect us unconsciously, meaning we likely don't know or believe we have these. Back in the 90s, a doctor named Tony Greenwald invented a way to test for it, and it's what's now the most commonly used implicit measure in psychology, the implicit association test.
I was looking for a way to measure attitudes without asking people what their attitudes are, because I and many others think that self-report measures of attitude are often quite distorted, because people will, particularly when they are being asked whether they have prejudices, will deny it when in fact they may have prejudices.
Bias is a natural part of how the brain works and the human condition. So if you are human, you have bias. And I think that first point is important for people to recognize, that having bias or taking the IAT and having it tell you you have bias is not some flaw in your wiring. It is actually your brain working exactly as it's designed.
There is a public version of this test that anyone with a spare 10 minutes can take online, and it's called Project Implicit. Here's how the implicit racial bias test works. The first thing you see is a questionnaire asking you about your race, sex, education, etc. And it also asks how warmly you feel about people who are white or black. You're then taken to the main part of the test. It'll show you the faces of black and white people. And as fast as you can, you have to categorize them by their race, using certain letters on your keyboard. Next, you have to categorize words, like joy, as good or bad. Here's where it gets kind of tricky, because the categories, words, and faces start to mix. You are then asked to match faces with an association, and the words get flipped a bunch of times until the test is over. Dr. Greenwald says the reaction time for all of these can say a lot about someone's implicit bias.
The first time I did this, I just slowed down. And slowed down not trivially, but by what I thought was a huge amount. It was actually about a third of a second. That is in experiments that study reaction time effects among psychologists. One of my colleagues described that as an eternity.
In the end, it shows you what Dr. Greenwald calls an automatic preference toward white people or black people or somewhere in between. On average, about 80% of white Americans who took this test showed an automatic white preference. But what Dr. Greenwald finds really interesting is that about a third of black Americans also have an automatic white preference. Another third have an automatic black preference, and the rest are somewhere in the middle. But these findings, and the test in general, have been criticized by other psychologists.
One of the problems with this measure is what they're trying to do is they're trying to infer someone's true underlying attitude from a physical response, from how quickly you move your hands through a computer task. To what extent is this test predicting anything of any real consequence?
Dr. Jack Glazer is another psychologist, and he has a different perspective. He has worked with police departments across North America to better understand the racial disparities caused by policing practices and how to reduce them.
In the realm of policing, in particular, we know that police officers, like most other people, have an implicit association, meaning a stereotype in their heads that resides outside of their consciousness, and maybe also is conscious to some of them as well, associating black people with crime and weapons and violence. And so that very clear body of evidence enables me to say to police departments, even if you have policies that prohibit racial profiling, even if you have trainings that tell officers to not engage in biased behavior or to not use excessive force against people of color, there are these unconscious, automatic processes operating that are very difficult to control.
Other psychologists say there are more ways to learn about hidden bias.
I've had people over time, you know, make the connections as to why they might have avoided racial moments or conversations, or why they might have over-justified themselves, right, in a particular conversation around race. where other people are wondering, why are you protesting so much? The participants can tell us the gap between what I thought I didn't know and now what I do know, which is really making an implicit notion explicit.
So with a better understanding of the existence of inherent bias, the next step is recognizing our own, and then trying to understand why they exist by doing our own research.
I think sometimes our instinct, or people who really want to learn more about racial bias or the experience of Black people or non-Black people of color, their instinct is to call their Black friend. That can be really fatiguing for people of color to carry the burden of implicit bias and systemic racism, and also carry the burden of educating everybody that they know about what that's like. And instead of reaching out to Black people or people of color that you know to explain it to you, really reaching out to them to learn more about how they want to be supported in this moment.
Thanks for watching Global News. If you want to stay up to date on the latest breaking national and international news, be sure to subscribe to our channel.